Left to Envy, an Adele Sharp mystery, book 6. Written by Blake Pierce. Narrated by Abigail Reno. Chapter 1. Dawn introduced itself with interloping rays of gold through the multicolored glass, hiding things in the shadows of the archways. The sunlight scattered the colors from the stained glass windows across the long, swirling, circular mosaic floors. Docent Vicente stood behind the cordoned velvet ropes, one hand resting against the wooden privacy partition, and his other resting delicately on the cool silver knob of a cue divider. He smiled from where he stood in the threshold of the structure. For 10 years, he'd been providing tours through the heart of culture itself. And yet every day he felt the same sensation of wonder as the first time he'd set foot in the Sistine Chapel. More than half a millennium in age, heralding stories of a time past, but also suggesting of others to come. Not just the masterwork paintings, or the mosaic craftsmanship, but also a sense of holiness, of awe. He stood in the doorway, peering along the ground, breathing softly to himself, and murmuring a quiet Latin prayer, a morning ritual before every tour, a small consecration, an offering to join the many voices lifted up over the centuries. Vicente heard movement and he turned, smoothing the front of his uniform and glancing along the hall in the opposite direction of the main room. A custodian was pushing a small red bucket on wheels, a mop angled and brushing the man's shoulder. Vicente smiled and gave a little wave, still murmuring the prayer beneath his breath.
Saluto. Ready for the day? The custodian asked.
Vicente racked his brain. Timothy, he recalled. This was the man's name, yes? Yes. He paused the cadence of his prayer for a moment and adjusted his sleeves.
Buongiorno, Timothy,
he said, pausing, looking for a reaction. Nothing apparent, suggesting he'd correctly remembered the name.
Ready for our visitors?
The custodian grunted, silver keys jingling where he pulled them and began finagling with a small supply closet tucked behind the entrance foyer. Not all history could be perfectly maintained. Some additions, perhaps. But not to the heart of it all.
Tourists arriving soon, said Timothy. My work is done.
And good work, too, said Docent Vicente. Today will be a special day. I can feel it.
Special, I hope. Perhaps this means no one will stick gum on the walls this time, nor spill orange juice in the chapel.
Vicente bit his lip at the mere thought. He huffed a breath, shaking his head.
I certainly hope not. Good day.
The custodian waved vaguely, stowing his supplies and then moving off, away from the doors leading into the heart of the chapel. For his part, Vicente turned. He felt a niggling sensation of unease at the thought of gum or orange juice anywhere in the chapel. They had strict rules about food. The sensation of worry turned into an itch, somewhere just near the base of his neck, prickling along his spine. Muttering darkly to himself, Vicente turned and strode through the wooden divider for the first time, beneath the refracted, multicolored light. He strode beneath the sight of the rectangular paintings, swirling about the room and to the drunkenness of Noah. His gaze swept the cordoned area. No sign of juice or gum, at least. The custodians, perhaps, had done their job the night before. He made a mental note to remind the tourists this morning of the food policy, the way some people treated history itself. He shook his head, turning away now, and then stopped.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.